If God is omnibenevolent and omniscient, then why is there natural evil in the world, and why do some people suffer more than others?
You see, this question comes out because people subscribe to the Christian theology. This is Christian vocabulary, talking in schools, preaching Christianity. We understand this is a serious issue of suffering. So why is it difficult to believe in a personalized God? Because of this question. That is why monotheism, belief in a super person, hello chops, I'm in charge of everybody, I set you off, is in trouble, big time trouble. Because the amount of suffering in the living kingdom, forget about human kingdom, the living kingdom is so dramatic, so dynamic, so frightening, it'll make you shudder. Living things are killing and munching each other while they're alive. So personality, super person, hello, I'm omnipotent, I'm all powerful and all loving and all compassionate, I'm good, he's in trouble. Monotheism is in trouble. Same thing Hindu. Suppose you say, I believe in God as this or that, you are in trouble. If you say, I believe in God as Brahman, as a principle that unfolds in this manner, then you are safe. You're not sorting the suffering out. There's still going to be suffering. It's not really rational. It's not structured. Some good people get thumped and some bad people can enjoy. The suffering is, you know, in imperative. You can't stop it. But the way we explain is saying that this is the way the cookie crumbles. When the spirit manifests itself, a Brahman becomes manifested as the living thing, animals, plants, human, it is a habit of biting itself, destroying itself. So suffering comes. They kill each other. So it's not because there's a personal God that we can challenge, how dare he produce this world, because there's no God there. It's principle expressing itself. And in the process, it pays a price. Sometimes it gets severely whacked, sometimes gets severely punished. It's not because he deserves it. If you say natural disaster, you can't say, oh, these people deserve to be killed in the tsunami. There's no such thing in Hinduism. It says this is the way the world operates. This is the natural forces. We live in this and we have to pay a price for it. This is how humanity pays a price for living this world. Or spirit pays a price for expressing itself in this particular manner.